Yo, what's up guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are doing absolutely fine. If you're new to the channel, then pause, hit the subscribe button right now, because this video is definitely gonna help you out if you go to the gym, or if you are a fitness freak or a health freak, or if you want to know more about your health and nutrition, then you have to subscribe to the channel right now. So okay, let's move on to the topic of today's video, which is why you're not losing fat. You've been trying X, Y diets, you've been trying keto, vegan, paleo diets, and you're still not losing fat. And in this video, I'm gonna tell you why is that so. The number one thing that you're doing wrong is probably not tracking your meals, not tracking your macros. If you're not tracking macros, then you will not know how much amount of calories or a total amount of food that you're eating in the entire day and how much you're burning. So it is good to track your meals. I'll tell you an instance of how not tracking macros can cause a problem. Let's take peanut butter. Peanut butter is obviously healthy fats. It's high in protein. It's good for vegans. Now let's break it down. Peanut butter, one serving gives you about 200 to 250 calories, like 2 tablespoons of peanut butter. It will give you about 8 to 9 grams of protein, which is good. But if you're not tracking, then overall calories that will come from those 2 tablespoons of peanut butter is going to be around 200 to 250 calories. And if you keep eating that for like breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and alongside your normal meals, which are 500 calories each, and 500 calories of 3 meals, that's going to be 1500 calories. And 250 calories from one serving of peanut butter that you're taking 3 or 4 times a day, that's going to be another 1,000 calories. So you're eating around 2500 calories, plus the snack that you eat for evening. You have a biscuit or two with your chai, and that's gonna entirely mess your macros up. You're consuming about 2700 to 2800 calories, and that is probably not gonna take you towards fat loss, especially if you have a slower metabolism, or if you have a poor metabolism, especially if you are not burning that much amount of calories in a day. So now you understand why you should track your macros and you should keep a track of your meals in the entire day. The second thing that you're probably doing wrong is you're not focusing on your sleep. Now, I cannot stress on the importance of sleep more than this. You have to get proper 7 to 8 hours of sleep, and not just the quantity, I'm also talking about quality. You should not use your phone at least 30 minutes or preferably 1 hour before bed, before you sleep. Engage yourself in something which does not involve a screen. Don't look at a screen for at least 1 hour or 30 minutes before bed. If you do so, if you look at a screen 30 minutes before bed or 1 hour before bed, that light, the blue light, is going to mess up with your REM cycle, the REM cycles, rapid eye movement, which is actually responsible for your deep sleep, and your recovery will be messed up. No recovery or poor recovery will lead to poor fat loss progress. So make sure you get that good amount of sleep and you'll be good to go. The third and one of the biggest problems that I see people doing, the biggest mistakes I see people doing, is that they do a huge weekend binge. Like, not just one day, they do it on Saturday, Sunday both, and they end up screwing their entire mehnat, entire efforts that they've done over the week, over the course of Monday to Friday, and everything just destroyed, shattered in just these 2 days, Saturday and Sunday. Suppose, let's take a person who is eating 1600 calories every day for fat loss. Okay, this is not the exact amount that you should be eating. It really differs from person to person. So I'm taking a hypothetical situation where a person is eating 1600 calories every day, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, 1600 calories. Now on the weekend, ends up having 3800 calories and 3300 calories. Now the average calories that the person is eating is going to be around 2200 calories, which is not your burning calories. You may not be burning that much, or you may not be in a calorie deficit when you eat a huge weekend binge for both days. So ideally, I would say that taking one cheat meal per week is fine. It is all right. And I don't even call it cheat meal. I call it my treat meal. Sometimes I eat treat meals every week, once a week. Sometimes I just skip treat meals if I don't feel like, because my weakness is pizza. Let's face it. Let's be totally honest, I love pizzas, but that's only once a week, or maybe not even once a week, it's gonna be once in 2 weeks, and it entirely is fine. But if you have huge meals and lots of alcohol, and that you're gonna binge the entire weekend, both the days, not just one day, then it's gonna mess up your entire calorie deficit routine. Average and that's really bad. So make sure you keep a check on that. Now this brings me to the number four mistake that you're doing is probably having too much liquid calories. Now I'm not just talking about the Coke and Sprite and Thumbs Up. I'm also talking about these so-called healthy drinks that you have in the market, Raw Pressery, Gatorade, etc., etc. These liquid calories add significantly. Now it connects to the number one point that I told, not tracking your macros. If you're having a juice which has no sugar, it is fine, it's all right, but as long as you're tracking it, if you're not tracking it down in your macros, it's definitely gonna create some chaos in your entire week's progress or in your entire transformation fat loss progress. So drop the liquid calories, go for whole foods as much as possible in your diet, and you'll be good to go. The mistake number five that you're probably doing is you're not even doing it, actually. You're not doing a workout, or you're doing very lazy workouts. Now, I have actually seen people who tell me that when I ask them, what's your workout? What workout do you do? They tell me that I walk every day 15 minutes. 15 minutes walk, you get, dude, let's face it, okay? There's a difference between an activity and an exercise. Walking up the steps just to get to your home is not an exercise, but if you're actually taking some time out of your day, at least like 15-20 minutes out of the day, and just climbing stairs up and down, up and down, up and down, then that might still be considered as an exercise, but not if you're just getting something up or like just walking up the stairs to your home. That's not going to be considered an exercise, that's an activity. So you should be very careful with what you're doing and what you're saying, because lazy workouts are not even workouts. So if you're just walking up the stairs once or twice a day and you'll be like, yeah, my workout's done, man, this is the most I can actually get through, the best workout that I'm actually doing is getting off my bed or getting off the chair, then that is, do some workout at least for 20 minutes every day, which is a workout, an exercise, not an activity. So don't walk and tell me that you're doing an exercise. That's not going to help you create an ideal fat loss, an ideal calorie deficit for you. If you're at home, you can do burpees, mountain climbers, you can do split jumps, you can do jump squats, and these things are actually going to help you burn some fat, and not the walking or getting up the stairs, getting up and down the stairs. So that's it for today, guys. I hope you found this helpful. And if you did, you know the drill. Hit the like button, share this with as many people as you can, your loved ones, your friends and family, your gym buddies, your gym partners. Subscribe to my channel for more interesting content. I'm gonna be posting videos every week and plus bonus videos every week as much as possible. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you next time.